So because you're a very close friend of Kelechi Iheanacho, and we hear that he's been linked with a move to Roma. Roma targets Kelechi Iheanacho. Kalumba, let me start with you before I go back to him. Kelechi Iheanacho, he's doing very well for Leicester City. Is it the best time for him to leave Leicester and go to Roma with Jose Mourinho?
Well, as we know, we call him Kelsman, senior man, you know. Senior man leaving to Roma, if I were him, just like in our days, I think he's having a full-time and glorious time in Leicester. And if you ask me, I'll suggest, I'll ask him to retain this his heat now that he's doing so well in Leicester. Let him retain the heat. After this season, then he has made his mark gloriously, and I think that would be a good time for him to move to Roma. Remember, Italian league is not as easy as you think. I can tell you couples of players that have been in Italian league. Ronaldo of Brazil, he went to Inter Milan and he couldn't make it. So many of them couldn't survive in it. Moses went to Inter Milan and he left. So I think he should have more of swell time in Leicester before moving to the Italian side. I think that would be a good one for him, because right now he is at the peak of his career, banging goals and in fact being a man to recognize after every ceremonial match. I think he should remain in Leicester.
Let me ask, what sort of relationship do you have with Kelechi Iheanacho in the Super Eagles camp?
Yes, Kelechi is the kind of person, the first time I was invited, when I go to the camp, he was the first person that called me and said, you're welcome, Mogu John, I've heard about you, you're welcome, I'm cool, I'm open to you, anything you want, just let me know. He's a free person and we have always been together, you know, he's the kind of, his joke is a lot, so when we are going to training, we sing together, I'll be raising chorus, we'll be playing, so we... In that way, we get so close to each other. I'm always with him in his room. He talked to me, encouraged me, said, guy, don't give up. He told me that, you read my story, you know, a lot of things have happened to me. Sometimes you feel like I'm off, I'm down, but then I never give up. So please don't give up. I strongly believe in you, believe in yourself. You get to the top, and trust me, has been a good friend. It has been a good friend to me.
So, Roma, Jose Mourinho, he's at the peak of his form. He scored in the Super Cup.
Yeah.
Community Shield is the peak. Do you think he should go to Roma, even for the money?
For me, I would say no. For me, I would say no, because I'm going through the same thing right now with Enyimba, like other clubs from Nigeria and people coming in with a lot of money and all that. But then I'm looking at the future. That's what I'm looking at now. I'm the peak of my career with Enyimba. I don't have, just have to jump to into any offers. But if offer comes in from Europe, then we can consider and look like that. So for me, I won't advise him. I won't say it's the right time for him to move. I would say he should just I'll play a season with Leicester then before he can decide on where to go.
When you say, does it mean that if you get a good offer from any club in NPFL, you will not move?
Yeah, for me, for now I won't move. Because
for a NPFL record,
yes, for now, I
for 20 million, for 30 million.
Let me say something.
Because I know that Rivers United, let me make it very clear here.
I'm looking
Rivers
for
United,
him.
They're looking for you, they want you. But if they table 30 million naira for transfer, that's going to be a Nigerian record, and not a world record, a Nigerian record.
I know that is not possible in Nigeria League. So.
That's
not possible in Nigeria League.
If Wike wants to spend for him,
yes, because you can use money for one bridge and sign a player.
One bridge. Yes.
Well, I know we are having a sweat time at the studio. You can see us smiling because we have the Super Eagles goalkeeper. Jada, you know, couples of time I've been in this studio, and people think because I'm an ex-player of Enyimba and I've known it all. You see, I'm happy you heard from John Noble that any player in NPFL in Nigerian League wants to play in Enyimba Football Club. So you can see clubs are offering him bags of money, you know. If Noble collects those money, I think he can come and contest for governor in River State. But the man is telling you know that he wants to remain as Enyimba. Every player in Enyimba has a prospect. Every player in Enyimba has future, and you heard it from him. Forget their financial attitude, but the clubs are still moving. They are moving. So if you play for Enyimba, I think that's the most glorious club in NPFL. They have 8 Super Cup and 2 Champions League. Name it. They have trophies. No club in Nigeria has such trophy. And when you're coming from abroad, most of the African countries, you want to come and play in NPFL, I think the first person you have, before club you have, is Enyimba Football Club. So I tell you, there's something about Enyimba Football Club. Every player want to touch that pitch before going anywhere.
But we've seen Lionel Messi leave Barcelona to PSG for money.
Yes.
Because Barcelona couldn't afford him. So if are you saying that if Rivers United with the governor who is a big sports lover, and then Rivers United in the Champions League, and then with the right offer, say 30 million?
Well, I have told you the truth. See, I want to tell you
Messi
one thing.
Left.
Yes, let me tell you one thing. Rivers United. You see the way they play. They do money playing. Do you understand? In their game, it's about money. But Enyimba, I said it often here, but
Enyimba has been signing money. They also have the money.
They have the Enyimba has integrity to protect in Nigeria and Africa. Continentally, they have that perspective. Now, I give you an instance. Watch this Enyimba calf slot and watch Champions League for Rivers United. I'm not saying Rivers United will not do it because they have a very tactical coach, Egoma. But watch something about Enyimba and you come out. Don't be surprised. They will be the only remaining club in the continent.
We're still here. John, let's talk about the CAF Confederations Cup fixtures for your club and other clubs. Let's quickly look at the captions we have because we have we don't have too much time. Let's quickly look at it so that John can help us analyze these matches. We can build it up a little bit because, Rivers, we'll start with Rivers, or do we start with Aqua? Okay, yeah, let's start with Aqua United because they're going to take on Buluzaz. It's an Algerian side. You traveled to North Africa.
He has been to Algeria.
Yeah, you have been to Algeria. Yes, I remember. You played in Algeria. So tell us, Rivers United, what is it that about this North African side? What is it that you might want to share to Aqua United fans?
Yeah, for me, what I experienced with them is that the North Africans, their first 15 minutes, they make sure they score you. They give you pressure that first, they play kind of a pressure game that first 15 minutes.
Yeah.
They come on you, come on with everything, like everything. Once they get the goal, then they go back to settle. Then the second half, they come out that first 15 minutes. Then the last 15 minutes of the game, they come again. So that's the kind of game they play. So Aqua United have to be up and doing. They have to work hard.
You played against Aqua. You compare playing against Aqua and the North Africans. You think Aqua can stand? This is, be honest to yourself.
It's really going to be difficult. But then anything is possible. Anything is possible. And Aqua is a team that's full of dreams, and I strongly believe this year they will go far. But I can't say more than that.
Okay, let's stay with Rivers United because they take on Young Africans. Something tells me that I know that you've had offers from Tanzania League, but something tells me that Rivers United could just get something out of this match.
Yeah, I should really get something. Rivers United has always been good away when it comes to the continent. They have always been good away and they've always been good, but just that they are not lucky enough to skate through because of Enyimba was involved. Mm-hmm. So I strongly believe they'll get something good from away, if not a win but a draw, mm-hmm. I believe, and they will do well.
Can Rivers United get away points in Young Africans in Tanzania?
Well,
Simba not Plateau United last year.
Simba is a very strong side. Me and you know that. You can't compare Simba to
any Nigerian
team. When you talk of these Young Africans, I think they are talented and they have young players like they bear their name. But I want to let you know that Rivers United has not really gotten that continental experience. But you can't tell because Rivers United, they've been
but
very spectacular this
Dolphins,
season.
They went up to the... They under Dolphins, they played the finals.
Yeah, but you see, it's not about being experience of I was there 8-9 years ago. I'm giving you an instance with Enyimba. Every season they are in continental race.
So but when United was in continent last year also, they lost out to Enyimba. Unfortunately, on penalty.
Well, you can't really call that. You can't say they gathered experience because how many matches? I think about.
They played about 3 matches.
I'm just telling you. Anyway, thank God the Young Africans are not the strong side like Pyramid and
Al Ahly. They're not even as strong as Simba.
And the El Ahly and Zamalek and all of them. So I think they will excel through.
Okay, John Noble, let's talk about tomorrow's match, novelty match. It's nice. How often do you go to Gokana? Because you are like an Aba boy now.
Can you speak Igbo?
How do you stay in Aba? How do you see Aba as a city?
Yeah, Aba has been a nice place. It's a city full of business everywhere. So once you're in Aba, what is come to your brain is how to make money. Because everyone in Aba is up and doing every
exactly,
day. You wake
exactly.
up, you go to the street, everybody's hustling. At times I walk in the street of Aba, look at old women struggling.
Do people recognize you in Aba?
Yeah, very well. My jerseys are everywhere in Aba.
Dada, you can see the jersey. I got it when I went to Aba from Nobo. When you enter Enyimba Township Stadium and they have matches, come and see all the kids wearing John Nobo jersey. So John Nobo has spent so much in for his, you know, so, and you see it's working out for him.
Working out for you. So tell us, your stay in Aba and Port Harcourt, how do you go around in Aba?
Yeah, like I don't go out always.
Stay in camp.
Yeah, always in camp after training, rest. But at times I just like, okay, let me go to the street and see what is happening. At least if I get home, at least I'll have one or two things to tell my people that these were things I saw in Aba. Yeah. So
Gokana, you are from Gokana. Tomorrow it's a novelty match. For our fans who might want to come and because people are watching us here and people might want to come to Gokana tomorrow, can you assure people that Gokana is safe and secure?
Yeah, Gokana is safe and secure. Tomorrow we will have our security all over Ogoni, not just Gokana, because the players that are coming in are players that don't just have to be treated anyhow. So there's maximum security from today. If I'm talking to you now, everywhere in Gokana is tied up. Both from Thai, there's security to Gokana because of the game tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So hopefully we'll be moving into Gokana this evening and then we'll play the game tomorrow.
What's your relationship with Joseph Yobo? Because he's also an Ogoni man and he's in fact part of the technical crew.
Yeah.
So how do you relate? Do you speak your Maribo?
Yeah.
How do you work with Yobo?
Yeah. Yobo has been a father to me right from in the national team. Like I remember when we were in training, he said, Nobo, you should speak language, not always English. You have to speak language because we are one. So at times we speak language, so that makes that we are close. We are very much close. We talk on phone, we chat, we call, and I always check on him every day.
So you know what you are going to do for us? You are going to tell our viewers in Ogoni that they should come and watch tomorrow's match, and Ogoni is safe. And you know, just say something to our viewers in Ogoni, please, very briefly.
In Ogoni?
Yes.
Okay. Nkonepa Gokana Nepa Ogoni Koba Adu Orabuwe Ep match a Mugu Field.
What did you say?
I'm just kind of inviting people to come over tomorrow, and Gokana is safe. Gokana is safe for them to come and watch the game tomorrow.
All right, thank you very much, Joseph. John Noble has been our guest today. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much,
and Kaluba, thank you very much, and to the operations director.